Good evening. This is Orson Welles. Just saying hello before the show starts. We hope this finds you well and leaves you better. This is your radio almanac, the first of a new series. An almanac, you remember, usually has at least a little bit of just about everything. And, well, that's us. Mostly, we want your almanac to be fun for you, real fun for all of you, wherever you are. This is January 26th, St. Polycarp's Day and the eve of the Feast of St. Chrysostom. There was a new moon yesterday morning at 8:33 at 4 degrees Aquarius. Our astrology department says for me to tell all you Aquarians who were born this week that you're in for a very active year. They want me to say that everything looks pretty good for you. 156 years ago today, the British settled Australia. I mention these things because they belong in an almanac. And here's another interesting item. 3 weeks ago today, exactly, Dick Tracy was kidnapped by Flat Top. Homely philosophy and nuggets of wisdom come later, along with Groucho Marx. January 26th, our time, 1944, is the date Groucho Marx appears on this show. At the sign of the Flying Red Horse. I beg your pardon?
I said,
It's very pretty, but what does it mean?
Well, it means we just can't tolerate this sort of thing. You see, I'm from upstairs. My name is Mr. Trivers.
Oh, yes, the censor. The censor, better known as vice president in charge of... That's dirty. What's on your mind, Mr. Trivers?
We've told you a dozen times, Mr. Welles, that there's some things you can't do in radio.
Why, what have I done?
What have you done? Last week in your love scenes, you were breathing heavy again.
I was?
Yes, sir. You embarrassed the whole Middle West.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Trivers. It won't happen again.
Won't happen again? Look what you're doing now. You've got red horses flying around in here.
Now, Mr. Trivers...
You can't do that.
The flying red horse is symbolic. It's our signature. It opens the program. Let me show you. The makers of Mobil Oil and Mobil Gas, with their compliments, invite you to join us. If you're not careful, Mr. Trivers, you're going to wear out your Invite you to join us at the sign of the Flying Red Horse.
Tonight and every week at the same time over these same stations, the makers of Mobil Gas and Mobil Oil bring you Orson Welles.
Ladies and gentlemen, this particular new moon is a total eclipse of the sun. But despite the conjunction with the moon's south node...
Mr. Welles!
Despite the conjunction with the moon's south node and its opposition to Pluto, which give vent to the foregoing...
Mr. Welles!
...luminaries behold some very good aspects.
Mr. Welles, immediately after this broadcast, you're to proceed to the lobby of the Wiltshire Fish Market, which is having its grand premiere. You will remove your shoes, and at 11:55, imprints of your feet will be preserved for posterity in the fresh cement. There's just one other matter. I have to fill out these forms for Social Security. Now, the name is Orson Welles, and what is your occupation?
I'm a dispenser of wit and humor. I bring smiles to people's faces. I make the whole world laugh.
Mm-hmm. Unemployed?
You can say that again. Might I inquire, miss, who you are and what you're doing here?
Well, they sent me over. I'm Miss Grimmett, your new secretary.
I don't need a secretary. Who sent you over?
Your sponsor.
Oh. Well, pull up a knee and sit down. I guess I could use just one more little secretary. Now, on with the show. Did you know, ladies and gentlemen, that the average family in the United States consists of 3.5 persons?
Oh, isn't that kind of messy, having a half a person around the house?
I'd rather you didn't interrupt, Miss Grimmett. This is a radio program.
Well, you'd better look over your script first. I've made a few changes.
You've made a few changes?
Yes. You plan to introduce as your first guest star Cordell Hull?
Yes, I thought I'd start with the Secretary of State and sort of build from there. Great idea, isn't it?
No, I've canceled Cordell Hull. We can replace him with Frank Sinatra.
I'm sorry, that's out of the question. We couldn't possibly use Frank Sinatra on this program. These microphones have no handles. Got enough to do without picking him up.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the next item on your radio almanac is a little philosophical playlist, a drama. A censor again. What's on your mind this time, Mr. Trivers?
Oh, we fellas upstairs. We've just been studying your script. Now, this drama you got on for tonight. You can't do that on the air.
Why not?
Oh, Mr. Wells.
What is wrong with the love life of a gypsy moth?
Why, the sound effects alone are censorable.
What sound effects?
Well, take this one you got indicated right here.
See? Yes.
Sound of two caterpillars necking. That's got to come out.
But why? What a wonderful thing. I say, just imagine, if you will, two caterpillars necking. Listen to them. There's a pause, and we hear nothing. Now, see, caterpillars being so soft and silky, they don't make a sound when they're necking.
That's what I mean. Much too suggestive.
Well, now, what's suggestive about it? These caterpillars aren't making a sound.
That's just it. They're being very sneaky about it.
All right, we'll cut the caterpillars. Will you, sea lions? You have to have a fish in your pocket. Any other complaints?
Yes, scene three. The one about love at first
love
sight.
Love at first sight?
Yeah, that's
got to
come out.
Which scene is that?
Well, it's this one here. See, where the moth flies into the closet and sees a sweater.
Well, that's a charming scene. What's wrong with this?
Oh, come now, Mr. Wells. Whose sweater did you really have in mind?
What do you mean?
You know very well, Mr. Wells, that when you put a sweater in this story, you were thinking of only one person. And I don't mean John's other wife. I'm afraid, Mr. Wells, I'll have to cut the whole script.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you will send a stamped self-addressed envelope together with two feathers from the wings of the Flying Red Horse and 25 cents to cover handling and mailing, I will send you the censor.
Orchestra playing I Know That You Know.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that was what she said it was. Thank you, Miss Grimmett. I don't know about almanacs, but in every radio show along about this point, a charming fellow walks up to the microphone, beats you over the head with a commercial. You've heard him. Says, folks, have you tried Perkins Pickles today? Why not? Don't you know that Perkins Pickles are tangy? Haven't you heard that Perkins Pickles are cram full of squishy goodness. Friends, Perkins pickles are scientifically grown to contain 108 warts per pickle. If Perkins finds a pickle with 107 warts, he throws it away. And remember, Perkins pickles, spelled backwards, reads Selkip Snickrip. We don't have an announcer like that. We have a fellow, his name is Ray Collins, by coincidence. Very nice boy. Unquote, reserved. Very reluctant to talk about the product. So let's all give him a nice round of applause. Here he is, Ray Collins.
Hello?
See what I mean. Ray, isn't there something you'd like to say to these lovely people?
No.
He wouldn't last long with Perkins Pickles. Ray, there must be something you want to say to them.
Yes, there is something I'd like to say, but don't you think it's a bit late for
us? Not at all. It's the time for it. Go right ahead.
Happy New Year, everybody.
Well, that's very sweet of you, Ray, but I was thinking of something else. Have you done any writing lately?
Oh, sure.
Well, tell the folks about it.
Oh, they wouldn't be interested in my bicycle.
Your bicycle is not what I'm talking about, Ray. You drive a car, don't you?
Oh, sure.
Well, how do you make it go?
Why, I turn on the ignition. Well, just what are you getting at, Orson?
I don't want to be obvious about this, Ray, but when you drive a car and you want to get plenty from your ration coupons, you just...
Oh, you mean mobile gas.
That's it.
America's favorite gasoline.
Right.
Oh, well, sure, Orson. When it's miles that matter, people say mobile gas. Mobile gas is crammed full of miles. All the miles it's possible to give you under wartime measures. Oh, sure, other gasolines are good, but all I know is in wartime as in peacetime, mobile gas remains America's favorite. And 20 million drivers can't be crazy. Why, it looks like love, the way your engine and this master gasoline team up together. The qualities of mobile gas are outstanding with respect to mileage and power. The two things that count most today. On your speedometer, mark the miles you get from every gallon. And is there anything that you want more from gasoline today than mileage?
I think I can say without fear of contradiction, Ray, that what we want is mileage.
Mobile gas, Dr. Wells. Mobile gas. Friends, stop in at the sign of the Flying Red Horse. Get your miles worth from your gasoline coupons with mobile gas.
Well, thank you very much, Ray. And ladies and gentlemen, there's just one thing I'd like to add. We don't make any exorbitant claims for our product. We're all adults. I don't think any of us are taken in by some types of advertising. However, mobile gas does contain vitamin A. No other gasoline can make that statement. I beg your pardon? Pardon me, folks. I just found out we can't make it either. We continue now, ladies and gentlemen, with old Dr. Wells' almanac and joke book, Depressing Information Department. In the islands of Hawaii, and this is true, there is a law dating back to King Kamehameha which prohibits lovemaking on the public highways. Encouraging information department, powdered glass is not poisonous. Mystery writers, please note, powdered glass is not poisonous. Old Dr. Wells, however, doesn't recommend its use as a substitute for powdered sugar.
We interrupt this program, ladies and gentlemen, to bring an interruption.
Groucho Marx. Well, Groucho.
Thank you not to interrupt my interruptions, Wells. So this is the new Orson Welles program, and you're the new Orson Welles. Well, you don't look new to me. In fact, if I ever saw a used Orson Welles, you're it.
You're partially correct, Groucho. This is a new program, the Orson Welles Almanac.
Oh, it is. Well, did you know, Orson, that yesterday was the 150th birthday of Robert Burns? And after writing poetry for all these years, he winds up in Van Buren, Arkansas, playing a bazooka?
Did you know, Groucho, that Professor Unger Dunger of the Harvard University Sociology Department has just turned in a Ph.D. thesis proving that most people would be better off if they hadn't been born?
Yes, but that seldom happens to anybody.
Groucho, tell me, what are you doing here?
Your sponsor sent me over.
Oh, you know my sponsor?
Do I know your sponsor? He's over at my house every night drinking Pabst Blue Ribbon beer. Had to wait for the second page for that. How do you think you got hired?
Oh, gee, I thought he drank nothing but mobile gas. Now that you're here, Groucho, perhaps you can help me with a problem. Where am I going to live out here in California?
Why don't you come and stay with me in Beverly Hills?
You're joking. What sort of a neighborhood is it?
Judge for yourself. On one side of me lives Betty Grable.
Oh, who lives on the other side?
Who cares?
I take it you're fond of Betty Grable.
Well, I lean towards that type.
You do?
Yeah, I lean towards her, but Harry James keeps pushing me away. To get back to you, Orson, something I'm not crazy about. You'll be crazy about my place. All modern improvements. Gas lighting, inner door mouse traps, and a pot-bellied stove in every room. That is every room except mine. We couldn't get a pot-bellied stove for my room, so we hired Sidney Greenstreet to stand in the corner.
I don't know. Do you think I'd be comfortable there?
Why, you'll be as comfortable as a bug in a rug, and we got some of those, too.
I'm afraid I couldn't impose on you, Groucho. You see, I left my ration book in New York.
What if you haven't got a ration book? I'll take care of you. What's the best food in the world? Milk. Where does milk come from? Cows. What do cows eat? Grass. You can eat grass, too. And who knows? No, it's impossible. So you see, you'll be very happy at my place.
I'm sorry, Groucho. I'm afraid it's out of the question, especially if I couldn't get anything to eat.
Well, you can't have everything. Look at Solomon with 1,000 wives. Do you think he had everything? Well, maybe he did. My luck, I had to think of Solomon just now.
Suppose I did move in, Groucho. What would you charge me?
Money. You speak to me of filthy legal letters. Only a cad would take money from a friend.
Well, I'm glad to hear you say that, Groucho. Shake hands with a friend.
Shake hands with a cad. Would $500 a month be too much?
Oh, come now, Groucho. Money isn't everything. Can money bring you happiness?
No, but I like to have it around so I can choose the type of misery that's most agreeable to me.
Pardon, Mr. Wells. I have a message for a Mr. Marks.
I'll take it. He's a friend of mine. In fact, we used to know each other. Ah, he was a great guy when I had it. What's the message?
There's a milkman outside. He wants his horse back.
Tell him he'll have it back the first thing Friday morning, as soon as I get back from my ranch.
You a rancher?
Why, only this morning. They sent me 600 head of cattle.
Jerseys or Holsteins?
I don't know. They only sent the heads. I think they were the heads. Now, look here. Now, look here, Prairie Flower.
Take your hands off me.
Don't get excited. I'm just trying to trace my 600 sides of beef.
Miss Grimmett, certainly you recognize Groucho Marx.
Indeed. You know, Mr. Marx, I can hardly wait for your program to come on the air every Saturday night. So I usually don't.
We're going to get along gloriously, Miss Grimmett. Couldn't we steal away somewhere together after the program, just you and me?
Put me down.
Quiet. Do you want to get into pictures? Oh, you can't fight it, Miss Grimmett. It's bigger than we are. Can't you see us sitting on a park bench, you and me? No moon, no stars. Just a beam from a policeman's flashlight.
Well, did you ever?
Who, me? Oh, once or twice. Orson, who is this woman?
My secretary.
Come, come, Orson, secretary indeed. You can fool me once and you can fool me twice. But you can't fool me all the time. Remember, I'm some of the people. Now, come clean, Wells. Do you or do you not want to get into pictures?
Put me down.
Oh, pardon me, Orson. I always wanted to pick you up.
So you're a producer now?
Certainly. Shall I draw up the contract?
Oh, you're a lawyer, too.
Yes, and you'll have a contract as soon as we can get hold of another lawyer.
If you're a lawyer, Groucho, why don't you handle it yourself?
I don't fool around with shysters. Now, the first thing we do is to give you a big publicity buildup. Monday, you get lost in the desert. Tuesday, we send Hetty Lamar out to look for you. Wednesday, I go out to look for Hetty Lamar. And Saturday...
Wait a minute. What happened to Thursday and Friday?
I found Hetty Lamar. And don't interrupt. Can't you see we want to be alone? All right, Orson, there's your contract. The party of the first part, hereinafter referred to as Orson Welles, agrees to appear in 7 pictures the first year, 12 pictures the second year, and 18 pictures the third year. Welles, you're fired.
Fired? What for?
You're making too many pictures. The public is sick of you. Miss Grimmett, my cloak. And Orson, put 2 pair of shoes on the flying red horse. I'm getting out of here. Goodbye, everybody.
What happened, Groucho?
Silly horse. I told him he couldn't wear wedgies.
It says here I'm next.
Go right ahead, Raymond.
Thanks.
All right.
Well, sir, I like good round figures myself. Don't you, gentlemen?
Oh, you old devil.
Well, especially, I might say, when they're revealing.
Well,
these figures are 70% of all the cars on the road today
are
from 5 to 10 years old. 70%. New cars will be scarce for a long time after the war's end. Folks, you've got to take care of your car. That means frequent oil change, and that means Mobil Oil. Perhaps you think because you're making shorter trips at lower speeds, you needn't change your oil so often. On the contrary, under these conditions, oil is apt to get dirty quicker. That encourages burnt bearings, worn out cylinder walls, and wasted gasoline. So change oil frequently and change for good. To good, fresh Mobil Oil. It helps your car run better, longer. Drive in at the sign of the Flying Red Horse for Mobil Oil.
Department of Interesting Statistics, Mobil Oil is the world's largest selling oil. Ladies and gentlemen, you're about to hear from one of old Dr. Wells' favorite songbirds, and one who looks just as good as she sounds. You're going to agree that that's quite something. The name is Martha Stewart. Miss Martha, tell the folks what you're going to sing for them.
Besame mucho. That means kiss me a lot.
Ladies and gentlemen, what you've just heard is the title of what you're going to hear. It does not constitute an endorsement of old Dr. Wells.
Besame, besame mucho. Each time I cling to your kiss, I hear music divine. Always be mine. This joy is something new. My arms enfolding you. Never knew this thrill before. Whoever thought I'd be holding you close to me, whispering, it's you I adore. Dearest one, if you should leave me, life would be through and you.
By the way, the president will be 62 years old Sunday. Happy birthday, Mr. President. Here's my dime. Sunday is also the 7th anniversary of Hitler's repudiation of the Versailles Treaty. And 5 years ago today, the loyalists surrendered Barcelona to Franco. You know, just about the longest, loudest argument in our United States history has to do with states' rights. I saw the word states' rights in the headlines this morning. And 114 years ago today, Daniel Webster stood up on the floor of the Senate and spoke for that other sentiment. You all remember how it goes. Most of us had to learn it in school. That other sentiment, dear to every true American heart, liberty and union, now and forever, one and inseparable. While we're on the subject of liberty, particularly eloquence on the subject of liberty, let's celebrate Thomas Paine's birthday 2 days early by reading a few lines of his, lines written in 1776. I call not upon a few, but upon all. Not on this state or that state, but on every state. Up and help us. Lay your shoulders to the wheel. Better have too much force than too little when so great an object is at stake. It matters not where you live or what rank of life you hold. The evil or the blessing will reach you all. The far and the near. The home countries and the back. The rich and the poor will suffer or rejoice alike. The heart that feels not now is dead. The blood of his children will curse his cowardice, who shrinks back at a time when a little might have saved the whole and made them happy. By perseverance and fortitude, we have the prospect of a glorious issue. By cowardice and submission, the sad choice of a variety of evils, a ragged country, a depopulated city, habitations without safety, and slavery without hope. Look on this picture and weep over it. And if there yet remains one thoughtless wretch who believes it not, let him suffer it unlamented. Where was there ever a war in which a world was defeated? Till now. Thomas Paine wrote the words you've just heard. They apply very well to this year of grace, 1944. I think they apply very well to the fourth war loan drive. I leave it to you. Now it's time to say goodnight. And please, if you've enjoyed this program, let us know about it. And more important, if there's anything you like or you think you'd like changed, write us care of the station where your double will find us next week at this same place on your clock. The makers of Mobil Oil and Mobil Gas, Agnes Moorhead, Martha Stewart, Ray Collins, Lud Gluskin, all of us in the Mercury Theater, want this show to be exactly according to your specifications of a good time. Until then, ladies and gentlemen, I remain as always, obediently yours.
Car on the home front is as vital to victory as a long Tom field gun on the battlefield. Keep it rolling with expert care at the sign of the flying red horse.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, they want me to make an announcement which it seems I forgot all about. So I'm going to ad-lib it. If you'll excuse me, it won't take a second, but I think we've got just a second. We have a guest next week, and I forgot to tell you that we have one. And he's an old friend of ours, a very distinguished lecturer, a world authority on undersea life, treasurer's reports, and other curiosa of the American scene. I know you'll be as happy as to hear about this gentleman as I am to be able to announce he is coming with us, the distinguished lecturer, author, and world authority,
Mr. Robert Benchley.
Groucho Marx appeared through the courtesy of the Pabst Brewing Company. Martha Stewart and Ray Collins appear through the courtesy of Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer Studios, producers of the current hit, Madame Curie. This is the Columbia Broadcasting System.